Welcome everyone, welcome back. My name is Stefan and this is our Tuesday video, the Tuesday, the day that I can finally talk about things and make light-hearted content. Today we're going to be talking about cooking stocks. Let's go. So welcome back to my little office here, you know, with my little setup. As you can see, there's some little things happening here, and I've got my little book and all the things I want to talk about. And here we've got a pre-made chicken stock. And the reason I've got this on the table is because I want to address some of the concerns and the question I've been having on the comments when I've made a few cooking stocks. I've been using ready-made stock to make stock. And I think this has been it has bring a certain outrage amongst people, you know, and there's been a lot of passionate comments like, what on earth is he doing? Is he using a stock to make stock? That doesn't make sense at all. What a moron. So anyway, of course, if you know me, if I do something, it's not just like this, you know, out of chance, or I'm not improvising. Everything I do is usually based on certain books or techniques that I've read somewhere, so either it comes from a chef or a culinary school books, for instance, or in this instance, this book. And this is the Auguste Escoffier Culinary Guide. Now, this is the book I'm usually going by to. This is my reference, this is my base. So my style of cooking, you want to define my style, I'm really following the Escoffier way. Some people would take, you know, other model, but this is for me, for French cooking, the kind of the base. Now, to answer the question, why did I use ready-made stock to make a stock, it's very simple. And for that, you need to understand a little bit more about what cooking stocks are in the view of Auguste Escoffier, of course. And also, if you don't know cooking stock in French cooking, they are really the base and the essential ingredients that you use to make your sauces, to make your dishes. And this is what brings most of the taste to sauces. They are super, super important. Now, without going into too much details, Escoffier, when he explains how stocks are made and the different types of stocks, so we can have, you know, we have the poultry stock, the veal stock, the brown stock, the game stock, and there's also something he's calling the fond blanc ordinaire, which is the common white stock. Now, the common white stock for Escoffier is basically what replaces the water we use today. He didn't believe in just using water. So the fond blanc ordinaire, or the white stock, was a kind of a simple, well, in brackets, a broth that you would make first and have at hand, like liters of it. I mean, we're talking about the base, it starts on 12 liters, about 3 gallons, which is not suited for home, let me tell you that. But it will have this ready all the time, and that would be used to actually pour over other pieces of meat and poultry to start a stock. And this is why I've been using a ready-made stock that will kind of simulate that base. And I would then brown some poultry, whatever, and pour this over instead of water to have that kind of Escoffier effect. Now, the thing we need to keep in mind, though, is that we are, I am in a home kitchen. You know, I'm not going to fool you. I'm not dressed as a cook. This is a home kitchen of just 4 burners. You know, it's a small pantry here, a small fridge, and I don't have all the equipment nor the ingredients that a restaurant have. And I think it is a good thing to keep in mind when you're trying to cook French food and try to make great food and you don't have much time, because a lot of people tend to be carried away by, you know, this reference book and want to make the real thing. But these are aimed at restaurants, you know. The proportion we're talking about are like in gallons, you know. Small example, the normal white stock, the base, the broth, let's say, 10 kilos of pieces of veal and about 4 carcasses of chicken, a kilo of carrots, 500 grams of onion, 300 grams of leeks, celery, etc., and some other things. So imagine the amounts are huge just to make a simple, you know, broth on the side. So in my opinion, when people get passionate about this thing that I'm not using just the water and make the real thing, it's just because when you're in a home kitchen, you don't have time for all that, you know, it just does not make sense. So if you want to really get something that's going to get close to this kind of taste, you need to find ways to trick the system. So they're kind of little hacks, but because you can buy ready-made stock that someone has made already, it's not a bad thing at all, you know, and it's much better than just using water. Okay, so that's the one thing I want to say. This is the reason why in a lot of video you see me use stock to make another stock, because you got this double effect. Now, Escoffier, for instance, the brown stock, for the people that have been talking about, oh, how to make the brown stock, or even the chicken stock, he starts with the two types of stock. In one dish, you've got the bones, you've got the carcass, and that's gonna simmer with some water, it's making that broth, and on the other side, it's gonna pan with just the pieces of meat, the good stuff. Like I always say, keep the good stuff. Two pans, two reduction, and then he mix both together, reduce again to get like that kind of master stock. Of course, we don't have time to do that at home. You know, it's just impossible. So really, using my technique, and I will do some demonstration in a later video, it's a really good thing. And the reason I'm doing it is because you will really get that little bit closer to get a really strong taste. Now, another thing is also talking about the difference between the veal stock and the chicken stock. One thing I've done as well, I've been using not this chicken stock here, but the same kind of brand, but it was a veal stock, to make or demonstrate how to make a chicken stock. Another outrage on that video, and I understand, because people think, what on earth is he using a veal stock for a chicken stock? Same thing here. If you go into the resources and you know the real thing about stock, again, talking about the white stock, the common stock, the ingredients are composed of pieces of veals and poultries. So you always have chicken and meat mixed together, even if you're making a chicken stock. The chicken stock is basically the name you give because there's going to be a majority of chicken. So I quote here, when you want to make a chicken stock, the proportion would be the same as the common white stock that you would use as a base, but in addition, you would add a few more carcasses of poultry and three whole boiling hens. So you would add to that base stock a lot of extra chicken to, you know, top the taste over the edge and get that chicken stock kind of taste. So really, the fact that I'm using some ready-made veal stock, which is very thin, to make a big proportion of chicken stock does not matter. And the reason for that is because chicken stock, sometimes on its own, chicken is not very strong in taste, you know. And adding a bit of veal, which is also white meat, really gets you that kind of meaty taste, and you add some, you know, chicken wings or chicken necks or something like that to make a real nice stock in a minimum amount of time. And this is what I'm going for. And so what I will do, I don't want to give you too much information because your head's gonna go like gonna explode, but I will do some demonstration. I want to do this in the Tuesdays and going through this little like veal stock, chicken stock, and I want to adapt these things for home, really, because that's my mission. And I'm conscious we are at home and we need to make something that works at home when you don't have time. And I want to be able to make stocks that taste good, that are great, in about like 30 minutes to an hour maximum. This is my aim, this is my goal. Now, to finish, since we're talking about stock and I'm not gonna talk about it all the time, one thing we need to know about the stock is that you've got the common stock, which is the broth, to mix with everything that you can use. So this would be it. Then you can make either a brown stock, like veal or beef. You can make a chicken stock, and you can make a game stock or a duck stock or anything else like that. Now there's different levels of concentration in the stocks. The base ones are called stocks. That's good to know. So the first one is a stock. It starts like this. If you reduce it, again, it becomes an essence. So let's say you've got this amount of stock. I don't know the exact proportion, I need to read further, but if you go, let's say, halfway or maybe three quarters of the way of reduction, that becomes an essence. So it starts with stock, goes to an essence. If you reduce it again, you enter the glaze territory, which is like diminishing that amount of stock into like this. And there's like the demi glaze and the glaze. But in the book here, it's just talking basically about the glaze. So remember this to finish that video. when it comes to stock, you got the different stock of chicken, beef, veal, the white stock. That's the base. When you reduce it, you're going to go into the essence, and that's a level of reduction. And if you reduce more, you're going to have the glaze. It's not a new product. I've heard people talk, oh, it's a different thing, you do it differently. No, that's absolutely not true. It starts with a stock and it's just reduced, reduced and reduced and reduced, and it's concentrated more and more and more to give you the last thing, which is the glaze, which is like a super concentrated type of stock that we don't really use at home. Whew, that was a lot of information, guys, but that's it, I'm done. I wanted to take this off my chest. You know everything about the stock making, and hopefully you understand a bit more. I leave you to this, and don't forget, my Patreon page is live about now, so if you want to support me, always go to the page and become a patron. It's much appreciated. I'll see you all on Friday for the big recipe video. Have a good time.